This brings us to the quick topic of the fundamental theorem of line integrals. Now, in single variable calculus, we had the fundamental theorem of calculus, and what that did for us is build a connection between integration and differentiation. Because if we took the definite integral of the derivative of a function, so I had a function I took as derivative, so there sits the derivative, and I integrated, I'm back to the take the antiderivative, I'm back to the function, and I'm just subtracting that value at b minus that value at a. I'm just doing that subtraction. So that just connected the function, its derivative, and the integration thereof. So what do we do with the fundamental theorem? Let's put that in green. Now we get to the fundamental theorem in line integrals, which is there. And what we have, we've been working, if you paid attention, I hope you can see up there when I talked about the initial bit, the fundamental theorem of calculus. We've been writing this capital F with these line integrals, and what we meant by that is the fact that it's the gradient of a multivariable function in a vector. So x, y, comma z, or simply x, or x sub 1, x sub 2, x sub 3, whatever, whichever way you want to write the components, I write it as a vector. But if you had this function and you took its gradient, you landed up with this vector, with a vector function, because you took the partial derivative, comma the next partial derivative, comma the next partial derivative, so you land up, and this is called a vector field. And if it is the gradient of some function, we call this a conservative vector field. Now, a conservative vector field has certain consequences. And that does mean if we have the same initial point to the same final point, irrespective of the path we travel in, and that's called path independence, that our line integral was going to be exactly the same. And we've seen many examples now of that happening. So the fundamental theorem of line integral states that this line integral of f dot dr, f and r being vectors, equals this line integral of this gradient. These two are the same. The gradient of lowercase f equals this vector capital F. That just equals this function at b minus this function at a. In other words, I should have written a and b there, or could have written a and b there. So from some, and there's the final point and the initial point. So if indeed this is true, it makes this a conservative vector field. And that implies that in its path, there's path independence. No matter what path the particle takes to get there, this line integral, which for now for us denotes work, but we'll certainly we're going to look at other aspects of physics. It's not only work. We're going to do something slightly different to these line integrals. Lastly, we just have to mention that the C. This path that's taken can be piecewise smooth as well. Smoothness means you can integrate it all over. In this part where it is smooth, this piece where it's smooth, it means it's integratable over that whole path. Then there might be a jump discontinuity or whatever the next, so it needn't be, the whole thing needn't be smooth. But in the sections that fit along the path, as long as each of them is smooth, smoothness implies differentiability on each section, so that can be piecewise. And C must be in the interior of the domain of F. As long as it's within the domain of this vector F, this curve, this fundamental theorem of line integrals hold.